श्रीमती रामानुजायन मां टुडे वी आर जुबिलेंटली सेलिब्रेटिंग द टेक्नोलॉजी डे द डे ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी इट ब्लॉसम्ड पैरेलली विद द डे ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी It emanated simultaneously with the day of blossoming of this cosmos. Technology, as per the definition given by the philosophy, as well as the definition that has been given by the technocrats, technicians, and modern scientists, that deals with the culmination of the pursuit and purpose of knowledge. Knowing about a thing is an information, and orderly knowing about a thing with its structure, relativity, and function and application is known as knowledge. Collection of orderly presented information is known as knowledge, and that knowledge, out of an innovative temper, if it tempts a person to bring out a reality, to bring out a change. And to implant in the society a renaissance which caters to the development of the society, either in physical, psychological, intellectual, moral, cultural, social, whatever may be the grounds. So, the unit of information collected and placed that gives knowledge, and the source of blemishless, uninterrupted, focused knowledge and a faculty is known as science. So, science, it deals with the disciplines. It deals with each and every entities around us as well as the entities, the species themselves. It starts with knowing of each and everything by attention, curiosity, observation, experimentation, analysis, probe, scrutiny, etc. So this science has further two extensions. The second is the engineering and third is the technology. Then the knowledge which is in the crude form, that is in Sanskrit we used to trifurcate these things as sadhya vishaya jnanam sadhanam siddhi. Sadhya vishaya jnana is focused knowledge on a particular thing which we want to implement for a better and broader cause. And the same thing, if it has a sadhana, it should have a tool. And the science that deals with the designing of the tools, for example, the knowledge that gives the definition and dimensions of the textile, that is a textile science, and that deals with the process of engineering, that is the promotion of the tools, are the essential systems of mechanics, which are suitably meant for the operation of the execution, that is known as the engineering, and the application of the same thing. It means of productivity, augmentation in the productivity, quality richness, upgradation, enrichment, all of these things come under technology. So think a thing properly is science, and derive a tool for making your thought implemented, that is engineering. Make use of the tool and implement it, that is known as technology. So the seed of science has its branches of engineering which culminates into the fruit of technology. Still technology is an unripened fruit. The ripened state, that the capacity of the fruit of technology is all around peace, happiness, and socio-economical equality. That is the use of technology. So, it is the penultimate stage. Even though it may be the ultimate stage, it is the penultimate stage. And the ultimate view of the technocrats, or the ultimate destination of any technology, is to bring the fruits of universal betterment. Like a peace, harmony, etc. So that is the purpose of technology. There are two groups of study. One is the primitivism, and second is the anthropological history or the genetical history. According to the scriptures, they may say that even at the time of the so-called Stone Age or the Copper Age or the Neolithic Age, Monolithic Age, persons with advanced knowledge about navigation, aircraft engineering with palatial constructions, well designed, well dressed, well modified, well civilized, knowing even about the god, the prime of the world, they coexist. the identification of stone. The first tool taken was a stone. Then we used to define this technology in four ways. Number one, it is the knowledge of tool or craft. Tool is an independent element and craft is a compound of components made for a particular niche. So knowledge is jnana. And second is utility or usage, that is known as upayoga. And third thing is niyantrana, ability to control. And fourth thing is adapting to the environmental and contextual requirements, that is auchitya. So jnana, upayoga, auchitya, that must be blended with niyantrana, a person to control. These are the quadrilateral steps by which a person's technical nature or a faculty's technological nature is defined. You don't have any other fan facility? So this is how we define technology. And technology started with the stone, I have already told. It is known as the Aquilian stone. They used to say Aquilian stone in the media. Then with the invention of fire, there is a primitive technology. Technology day, we cannot fix any day. We can fix a day of technology as per a remarkable progress or success, or after any technocrat or any successful person. Technology day, when did it start? So it started with the stone, understanding of fire, making use of the basic rudimentary tools for survival, clothing, domestication of animals, how to design the pottery, then identification of copper, then agriculture, small system of basic weaving, coloring, etc. Then the famous wheel technology, then the writing technology it came, then salt, identification of salt, then bronze, then into iron, then the sundial for direction, timing, etc. They invented new things like glasses, even they invented. And all these things they come under the primitive technology. We used to define the era of technology as primitive technology, classical technology, medieval technology, contemporary technology, modern technology, and emerging technologies, and fictional technologies which are there in suspension. This is how we classify these technologies. So apart from these technologies, we have identified a lot of things. For example, understanding of an atom, movement of electrons and their flow as electricity. There are innumerable things like communication systems, then television, all of these things, various other systems of communication, information, knowledge sharing, and various other modes that are being implemented in the society over the era of several centuries. Not only they are having their own hallmarks and remarkable points, but still it is a never-ending perpetual journey into the unquenchable thirst of human being based on curiosity, necessity, emergency, also the process of augmentation of the resources and the balance methodology of preservation, conservation, reservation and distribution of the same. Now let us come to the modern systems as well as the modern schools of technology. Now basically we start with artificial intelligence. It is the advanced mechanical response of machines by which they can be replaced for human purposes and intervention. So it started with artificial intelligence, and also not only designing and engineering the other things, also self-engineering by means of chromosomal upgradation, cell culture, tissue culture and genetic engineering, genetically modifiable things on human evolution like whole body transplant, cochlear implant, retinal implant, then artificially insulating the motors and motion particles of the body for immobility. Then addition, what we call, it is known as neuro-hacking, and there is also one more portion which is known as a brain uploading, brain gate, brain port, innumerable things they have come in the genetic engineering. And the third thing is on transportation. There are two types of transportations. One is the earth-based transportation and second is the spatial transportation. Now recently they have come to the scramjets. They are of very totally unimaginable speed level by